And welcome to part 11 of Let's Play Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. Alright, we finished a lot of submissions. And now we're gonna go collect some Dragon Balls and wish for Raditz back to life. You know, who else besides Raditz? And Nappa and Kui. Let's bring Kui back to life. D metal. It's easier if I use that marker. Gingertown. Whoa. Probably talk to him.
Actually, all right. Where's the tour guide? Over there. Only got four more left. Check. Gotta go to the community. Ultimate Awakening water would be best. Yes, it would be. The Blake Bog. Is it? Yeah, on top. Top of that plateau. Cool. About your town. My game is lagging. Yeah, I'm not gonna train actually. Aren't I? Two more to go. Hunt for some more deers. Gotta go for the last Dragon Ball so I can make three wishes. Wolves. Rah, white wolf. Okay, let's go.
Go to Luca Village.
Stop lagging! All right. We should head to where Raditz the space pod is. Gotta collect some of that rainbow orbs. Okay. Yay, Piccolo's now level 50. Why are so many enemies chasing me? And Vegeta reached a level 54, nice. On, please. Nice. I can switch to Piccolo. Alright, let's go to the Dragon Balls. First wish, Raditz, Nappa, and Kui. Alright. Skip it. East Ravine area, Raditz, Nappa, Central Plains area, Kui, Central Plains area. Raditz should be here. Yep. And he's got two Cybermen. Well, if it isn't Raditz. You! What do you want?
pride of the warrior race. Raditz has been brought back to life with the Dragon Balls. See if you have what it takes to beat him on your own this time. We're gonna be Raditz again. So how does it feel to be brought back by the guy that killed you? What? You mean Vegeta didn't do this? I thought he learned about my death and wished me back. Vegeta doesn't strike me as the type of guy to bring back those that go down so easily. I just let my guard down for a second, that's all. I'm no pushover. I'm an elite warrior of the Frieza Force who's taken over loads of planets.
Fine. If you really think you're that tough, then prove it. It's just me and you now.
You're gonna regret messing with me. Why are Tao Pai Pai and Master Shen over there?
Well, we got two Cybermen to battle. They're level 25.
Stop lagging already. What's your point?
Damn it! How did you get this strong?
I refuse to be left in the dust by my worthless baby brother and his loser friend.
That's where your weakness lies. Unlike you, Goku doesn't make excuses for losing.
Shut the hell up! I am a proud Saiyan warrior! If I trained, you wouldn't be able to touch me!
Is that so? Then how about this? You train with us and show us what you can do.
Fine. I'll take great pleasure in surpassing you and making you beg for your lives. You'll wish you never had been dumb enough to give me this chance in the first place.
Man, Raditz really has a bad temper. Okay. Let's switch to Vegeta.
This Super Saiyan form kind of reminded me of Danny Fenton going ghost when his hair turned white and his eyes turned green.
Kui, and he's got Frieza officers.
Hey!
Vegeta! What the hell's going on? Where am I?
Kui's been revived with the Dragon Balls. Make him your new training partner. No dirty fireworks for me.
Why is he so scared?
Whoa.
You killed me, Vegeta. I don't give a crap about that. You're going to serve me as my training dummy.
You're kidding, right? Do you honestly think I'm just going to forgive you for killing me?
If you're looking to get killed again, that can be arranged.
No, I like how tough you are. I'm not going to take you on. I mean it. Think about it. I got blown away in one fell swoop, right?
You mean when you lit up in the Namekian sky like dirty fireworks?
Dirty fireworks?
You have a problem with that description?
No way!
I don't want to die like that again.
Hmm.
What's that?
Hmm?
Ha! Dumbass! No!
Whoa. He did the same move. Now let's battle with him. Queeze at a level 45. The Frieza officers are both at a level 42. What are you doing? All I gotta do is go Super Saiyan. Seriously, stop doing that, Kui. Now we've beaten Kui. What a pretty foolish guy Kui was. Up to your pathetical tricks again, huh?
I'm sorry, I was just messing with you.
Hmm, you still haven't learned your lesson even after dying.
You know, Vegeta, with that kind of power, you could actually beat Frieza.
Don't be ridiculous. Frieza already got what's coming to him. And it was we Saiyans that made that happen.
Are you serious?
So, Kui, you still have the guts to take me on?
No way. If there's anything I can do to help you, let me know. I'll lend you a hand any time.
Hmm. Well, I could use a new punching bag.
What?
Wow.
Why would Vegeta use Kui as a punching bag?
He really is a hopeless piece of garbage.
Are we friends now?
Now we can switch to Gohan for now. No, but first, I'm gonna check Vegeta's super tech tree. Nope. Nice. No. You gotta be at a level 100. You gotta be at a level 70. Brick wall. Nope. Nope. Okay, let's get to party. And let's see, switch to Gohan. There we go. And I'll check the Dragon Balls. 10 minutes left. 10 minutes. 10 minutes so I can spare. Oh, it's Nappa with the other Cybermen. Excuse me?
Huh?
What do you want, kid?
Saiyan power. Nappa has been brought back to life with the Dragon Balls. See if he'll become your training partner.
Yes.
The Saiyan power. Nappa's been brought back. And why is his armor on? He doesn't have his scouter on.
You ain't shaking in your boots. Guess you don't know who I am, huh?
We've actually met once before. Not so much met as...
That's fought. Excuse me.
I don't remember fighting a blonde runt like you.
Hold up. There is something familiar about you.
Wait. Nah, you can't be. Are you Kakarot's brat?
Huh? Yep, that's me.
There's something different about this punk. Whatever. I couldn't care less. What the hell are you doing here?
I'd like you to help me out with my training.
What the? I ain't no idea what the hell's going on here, but it sounds like you want me to be your friend. There ain't no way I ever go along with what Kakarot wanted, let alone his weak little punk of a kid.
You can find out if I'm weak or not by training with me.
What? You're pretty cocky for a little guy. You know, you wouldn't know, but Raditz was just as cocky as you at first. Then I put that long-haired chum in his place.
Looks like I gotta beat you around to show you who's boss. You gotta beat those two Cybermen and Nappa. Those Cybermen are at a level 26. Gotta go. Come on, guys. Nappa's almost down. Yep, he's down for now.
Vegeta levels up.
Sweet. No way! What's with this runt?
What do you think of me now?
If you're gonna play like that, then I guess I got no choice. Fine, we'll do things your way. I'm supposed to help you train, yeah?
Yeah, thanks.
Remember this, though. I'm a proud Saiyan warrior. Once I'm stronger than you, I'm the one who's gonna call the shots. Got it?
Sure, that's fine. Nappa has to be one of my favorite Saiyans. He's really awesome. I mean, why did he have to take off his armor in the first place? The fight Krillin, Piccolo, and Gohan easily.
And when Piccolo's like, hurry, Goku, and Nappa removed his armor, he goes like, oh yeah, much better. I should be able to make quick work of these pathetic weaklings. Wonder why Nappa's such a jerk.
Why are the skeleton bones? We got some Dino Fang. Cool.
You can't drive because you're a preteen, dude.
Preteens can't drive, you know. There were reported sightings of a giant ape, I wonder. Oh, you found me in a rather strange place, haven't you?
I occasionally venture out this way to gather materials for my research. Okay. Why don't we spend some time? Well, I should probably go. Over there to the Kodaiho lands and collect some more of these awakening water. Whoops! Didn't mean to knock my side of my earphones. Got a little too distracted. What in the world? All the cell games have been destroyed. Wow. I mean, why didn't Hercule bring Pizzazz, his, and Caroni, and who else? And besides Pizzazz, Caroni, and Pirohi. I think that tournament guy for the Cell Games, his name is Jimmy Firecracker, if I recall. That's his name, right? But he got the ultimate sick awakening water, dude. We got that. What's the deal, man? Whoa. Oh, come on, seriously. Okay. Let's check the Dragon Balls for how many minutes? 3 minutes left. Okay. And I'm gonna put Nappa and Raditz. Nope. And Raditz, the sadistic Saiyan. Yay. All right. So if I can put Kui right here. And boom. Wow. Kui can be used for training. All right. course. Yay, Dragon Balls. It's about time. Now let's hit the Ginger Town. We'll be able to wish the Cell Juniors and the Ginyu Force, except for Captain Ginyu, who's been turned into a frog. I should be doing training when my characters are fully leveled up, right? Of course. Secret Land of Korin. Why do these characters keep flying? Kind of reminded me of the Powerpuff Girls. They only fly, and the Rowdy Rock Boys too. Green meteorites? Are they lying to me? Next is Gizzard Wasteland. For the love of God, please load and stop lagging! Lag is starting to get on my nerves. Okay. Go over there. Got some refined iron. Sweet. Next. Kami House. Let's go to the Kami House. Yeah. Frieza is at a level 65. I'm not gonna do that. Running out of oxygen. Gotta get that Dragon Ball. And get out. Three more to go. Head to Orange City. The Dragon Ball is right where I'm gonna where it's gonna be. Got some refined iron. Okay, perfect. Nothing else. Let's head to Deluca Village. Lag is seriously killing me. Right. Crystal, gold, silver, iron, blue crystal. Oh, wow.
nice. From now on, I gotta collect some Dragon Balls. Only two more. So that I can wish the Ginyu Force and the Cell Juniors back to life. Okay. Next. Delenge Palnia. In the later saga, I probably might fight Dr. Gero in Android 19. Would I? But it would be even more annoying. But only Goku can fight them. If Frieza and Cell are wished back to life, only Goku can fight Frieza and Cell. See, if Ginyu gets returned back to normal, only Vegeta could fight him. Oh my god. Nice. Next we go to Good Idaho Lands to make things easier. Excuse me. Those guys are at a level 69. I don't think I'm gonna take them on. Whoa. Okay. Now would be a perfect spot to wish them back. Okay. So juniors, gain you force. Rare items, receive rare items that are difficult to acquire by normal means. That. Movie. The Cell Juniors have been revived in the Continent Center area. The Ginyu Force have been revived in the Southeast Mountain area. All we got is some rare items. We got Superior Awakening Water and Divine Awakening Water. Five of them. Cool. Whoa, what the? Yeah, only Vegeta can fight these Cell Juniors right now.
see here.
Vegeta, 6, 9, 8, 7, 1. Let's see here. Piccolo, Gohan. Oh, okay. Oh, wow. Those phantom rings are gone. It'll take about 30 minutes. This is where the Cell Juniors are. There's a total of 7.
Hey, you little freaks!
Yeah?
I owe you for the humiliation you caused me before.
Little nightmares. Vegeta's still sour about losing to the Cell Juniors in the past. Now's the time for him to reclaim his dignity. His pride.
I owe you for humiliating me. I want a rematch.
Yuck, yeah. Sounds like fun.
Alright, we gotta deal with 3 Cell Juniors for now. Level 47, 46. Both are at level 46. We'll have to keep beating the living crap out of these Cell Juniors. Are you serious? Okay, now go Super Saiyan. Come on. There we go. Stop that. What the heck is wrong with you? Oh, not the solar flare again.
Level 52.
Sweet. Time for round 2.
Heh. I guess I'm too tough for you now.
Yeah, yeah. We're next.
They're next. So, Super Saiyan, here we go. Oh, man. What? Seriously? If only Piccolo were close enough to use that explosive wave on those stupid Cell Juniors, he got a level 46. The same as last time. I got the same levels as last time in round 1 of the Cell Juniors. Now this is round 2. What is wrong with you, man? Oh my god. Now I'm going back to normal. Yep, I just did.
Fill up your key, dude.
Big Bang attack him. Boom.
He's gotten better since the last time they fought him.
Gohan reached level 62 and Vegeta reached level 56. And they're all knocked out, except for one.
You want some too?
Yuck, yeah.
That ought to put you in your place.
Hmm.
Consider yourself lucky. I'm actually in a good mood, so I'll let you live.
Kya kya?
Running away, eh?
Hmm.
Kya kya?
The Cell Junior gave Vegeta an item. Super Helade, 3 of them.
What's this, a tribute?
Hee.
I might actually be able to make some use of these little freaks. Fine, you better not let me down.
Hee. Now the Cell Juniors were being nice. Though they're very annoying. Yep. Next.
to Yamcha's hideout, but first we gotta be Gohan. I can't even whistle. I seriously can't whistle right now. Let's do it. God. I gotta switch to Gohan. So that it helps. Gotcha. Oh, the Ginyu Force. Okay, come on. These guys are giving me a headache. Oh my god. Let's just talk to Jace. What you doing?
Who are you?
I brought you back on planet Namek.
Whoa, I recognize that voice. You're the Pipsqueak from back on Namek.
Wait. You look completely different. What the hell's going on? Whatever. We gotta figure out how the hell we got here. Yeah, you look like you know something. Start talking.
The Ginyu Force tryout. The Ginyu Force has been revived with the Dragon Balls. Show them how much you've improved.
Let's do it. You guys are on Earth. You're here because we wished you back using the Dragon Balls. Mr. Ginyu got himself turned into a frog and wandered off somewhere.
What do you mean Captain Ginyu's a frog?
Did he screw up with his body change or something?
Why would you wish us back? We're your enemies, you know.
Well, I thought you might change your ways and maybe become our allies.
Allies? What, you want to join the Ginyu Force?
Huh? No, that's not what I... Oh, so that's it. You want to join the Force?
The Ginyu Force is an elite squad of warriors formed under the orders of Lord Frieza himself. Captain Ginyu was entrusted with selecting members for the team. Taking balance into consideration, he chose certain combat specialists. After selecting me as his protege, Captain Ginyu then chose Raccoon for his power and Bota for his speed. And then finally, to round out the team, he selected Gudo, who's not much of a fighter, but has the special ability to freeze time.
There used to be one more, Banyu the Brains.
Oh yeah, that girl who quit because she thought our special fighting pose was late.
She had no sense of style. But you, bringing us back so you could join the Force, that shows you've got style.
You're pretty weak when I fought you before. You're not strong enough to join yet.
But if we don't take five people for our special fighting pose, we'll look ridiculous. I guess we could make him a temporary member until we find the captain.
Good point.
We can't just let him join without some sort of test, though. I got it. Go over there and think of a stylish pose that'll knock our socks off. Do that and you're in.
A stylish pose?
Okay, here it goes.
How about this? Hideous!
That ain't good enough.
Do you even know what stylish means?
You should be ashamed of yourself.
That's awfully harsh.
I'm guessing you don't have any special abilities like Gudo's Time Freeze either. Sorry, but we can't let you join the Ginyu Force.
Oh, come on. Let's give him another shot. How about we test the little guy's power? You just want to fight him, don't you? You got me there.
Whatever. Then I'm going to fight him, too. I also want to see what he's made of. Hey, that's not fair. If you guys are going to fight him, then I am, too. I haven't had a good fight in forever.
That's more like it.
Oh, man, cool. Oh, right. If you can beat us in a fight, we'll let you join our ranks.
Fat chance that's going to happen, though. Well, we're going to fight these Ginyu Force. These guys are at a level 32, so here we go. We're going to fight Raccoon, Birder, and Jace one last time. Yeah, we already did. Boom. How cool can it be?
You gotta be kidding me.
His power is incredible.
Captain Ginyu would be proud to have a warrior this powerful on the force.
He's a tough little guy. I got no problem letting him join.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, okay. Your poses are garbage, but spend enough time with us and he will help you get better. I wonder if it's a good idea to befriend guys like these. I guess I should work on my poses too, huh? I might end up having a use for them in the future.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Now we're going to be ending this saga. The Cell Saga and the Android Saga by talking to Chi-Chi after my training. Let's head in there. Let's make a full course meal. Special meat course. Right. You get 25% EXP. Wow. Man, that's a lot of meal. Okay. I wonder if I can go to the community first. I should bring Corrin into the adventures. Wow, Yajirobe's just bossy and rude. He doesn't have to be rude, does he? Okay. And Chiaotzu in the cooking. Right. Let's bring him, put him in the cooking. Let's put the Ginyu Force in. Like Raccoon. He's kind of bulky. Birder, Jace, and Godo. Can't believe Godo got decapitated in the anime. Why did he get decapitated in the anime? Can't believe Vegeta cheated.
He went like this. You dirty Saiyan! You really think you can get away with this? You're nothing! Just a stupid monkey! I belong to the Ginyu Force!
How rude and offensive to call a Saiyan a monkey.
You know how would Vegeta feel if you call him a monkey? He'll get mad. He'll freak out.
Key defense.
Yeah, the awakening waters are best.
Hurrah!
Okay. Oh man, you need like 120. That isn't enough.
Launch? That's not enough.
She's called Roshi a geezer. How disrespectful can she be?
Come on. Oh. Seriously, oh, come on. If I could put Kami here. Kami. Ten training? Wow. No, it won't be enough. Maybe I ought to put him here. Put King Yama. Yama here.
I think it's better to use awakening water for sure. Okay. Wow. That's not going to be enough. Probably need to put Yamcha on the warriors for now. And Tien as well. Nope, let's... No. Should give Chi-Chi the ultimate awakening water for now. That would help. We can give her another awakening water. Alright. I'll be able to end this saga. This is the great Saiyan man. Oh, now Gohan's 16 years old and he's fighting criminals. And there's Videl. From Super Saiyan to superhero. Oh man, Gohan is way too late. School days. Head to Orange Star High School. Yeah, Gohan is now voiced by Kyle Hebert as an adult. He's now 16 years old. You can't fly, nor can you fire your ki blast. Seven years have passed since the fight with Cell. Gohan, looking to realize his dreams of becoming a distinguished scholar, enters Orange Star High School to continue his education. Okay, guys, this is where we're going to meet Gohan's classmates, Erasa, and Videl, and Sharpener. Sharpener is voiced by Duncan Brannon, and Erasa is voiced by Alexis Tipton. But in the anime Dragon Ball Z, she was voiced by Laura Bailey, who also did Kid Trunks. And she also did Husky from Dragon Ball, let's see here. Akane from Dragon Ball, the one with in Penguin Village on the General Blue Saga. And Laura Bailey also did the voice of Upa from Dragon Ball Revenge of King Piccolo. Besides, she also does the voice of Dende in the Funimation of Dragon Ball Z. And she also did Oceanus Shenron in the Princess form. And besides, who else? She also did Gotenks. Videl is voiced by Kara Edwards, who also did Goten. But right now we're doing baseball. Home run game. This game's a battle of battling skills. Batting skills. Okay, let's try again. This game's a battle of batting skills. Swing your bat at the right time with the B button to hit the ball and send it flying. The more precise the hit, the further the ball goes. Different pitchers have different types of pitches, but don't be fooled by the ball's trajectory. What's most important is that when you swing your bat... Okay, you gotta make sure you beat his record. Play ball! Whoa! Yay! A home run! Uh-oh. Now Vidal's gonna find out. So that's Majin Buu's saga. The main villain is Bobbity, and there's Deborah, Pui Pui, and Yakon. Oh, Yakon was voiced by Chris George in this game, who also does the voice of, let's see here, Saito from My Hero Academia. He's the guy with a sugar quirk. And so after school, Gohan made his way to West City and stopped by Capsule Corporation. New encounters. People might realize you're the Golden Fighter. Go get some advice from Bulma. You have to talk to Bulma first. Yeah, Bulma's now wearing a red dress and she had a haircut. Wow. And she has a yellow scarf. Oh. This is where we're going to have to find Trunks. Go meet Trunks. Yeah, Trunks is all grown up. Except he's a little kid. And this is where Gohan meets Trunks. And Trunks is now voiced by Alexis Tipton in this game. Oh, Vegeta's wearing a different outfit and he's not wearing a Saiyan armor? They were training in the Gravity Room by becoming Super Saiyan. Ask Bulma if your new outfit's ready. And Trunks went Super Saiyan. And Vegeta gave Trunks a condition to hit him so he could take him to the amusement park. Why would he do that? Wow. Great Saiyan man. Now he's wearing a helmet. My frames are dropping, aren't they? Oh, there's Goten. This is Goku's second son. He's voiced by Kara Edwards. She also did Bubble Girl from My Hero Academia. Patrol the streets of Satan City. Gotta destroy those bases, enemy bases, first. should have known that there's going to be more bases in every saga. Enemy bases. Like Frieza's spaceship and the Muscle Tower. Yay, rainbow orb, sweet. Gives you incredible power. Gotta patrol the streets of Satan City. Whoa. Oh crap, more robbers. Oh, Videl's being ganged up by a bunch of robbers. Now Gohan went Super Saiyan and kick the robbers down. Now Videl knows the identity of Gohan. Of the great Saiyan Man, and Videl, and Gohan stops Videl from flying away. Videl is the daughter of Mr. Satan. After school, Gohan goes on the top of the building of Orange Star High School and changes outfit to a Great Saiyan Man. Alright. But for now, we're going to be doing some submissions. We'll be doing submissions in the next video. Okay. See if I can check Gohan. Gotta take down 25 foes, right? Still killing more enemies first, so I could level up to 64. And then I can end the stream. Well, I'm bad, guys. Face me. There's that rainbow orb. Yay, level 64. Okay. All right, level 64 is there. Okay. Now it's time to end this stream. Okay? We'll be talking to Videl in the next video, guys. Okay, everybody, I'm GabrielGaming5000K. I'll see you in the next video.